Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship at United Lutheran Church, and special welcome to visitors that are with us via Zoom. I think some of them are part of the baptismal family. So I get to introduce you to baptize today is Elena Frances Alonzo Millar. And look forward, and did I get that pronunciation? All right, I did. And she is the child of Felipe and Lainey. And so excited to have them with us. They've been joining us via Zoom, and I know some grandparents and sponsors are with us as well. Also today, we have blessing of graduates part one. We're going to do it in two parts. David, I think, is joining us online. And we had our high school, because next week, David would have joined us next week, but he will be out of town. And this week, we have Kevin that's with us. And Kevin, we're celebrating you and your graduation, and so glad you're with us. So, a few announcements coming up. First of all, council is this Thursday, and so take note of that. Also, we have a couple things coming up that are a little different. First of all is Camp Noah, and Camp Noah is for those middle school folks. Actually, they're doing a pilot program at Camp Lutherwood, and so look for information to come. It's in August for middle school kids that were victims of the fires up the McKenzie River and in other parts of the state of Oregon. So we will be doing some fundraising, trying to work with other Lutheran congregations, interdenominational congregations to raise money for that. If you're interested in that, you can talk to either Andrea Schofield, who is the director there and a member here at United, or myself. I will be kind of keeping up to date with what's going on and how we can support that. We're talking about trying as a group of churches in this community to try to raise $10,000. So it's a big push, but for those who have been traumatically affected by the wildfires. Also coming up at Camp Lutherwood, and this you are invited to attend, on the last Sunday of the month, which I think is the 27th, I forgot to write down the date, we will be heading out to do a commissioning of those who are working the camp through the summer. And so that's gonna be from 1 to 3. If you please call the church office or call me and let me know if you're going to be able to be there from on Sunday the 27th, they want to count for lunch, and lunch will be provided for those folks. So again, Camp Lutherwood on the last Sunday, which I think is the 27th. Let's see, what else do I have? Baby care kits. I'm going to hold this up. So Candy Snook has been working very diligently on kind of putting these together, and we're getting there. We are asking for donations of about $30 for a kit. That would be for one kit that goes to baby care kits for Lutheran World Relief. We are also collecting some things, and the most needed items, I believe that Crystal and Candy told me right now, are hand towels and bars of soap, and also flat fold diapers. So if you want to donate those, you can drop those by the church office, and Candy will make sure they get it in the kits, and she'd always love a little help with that as well. So just call Candy or call the church office, and we can connect you to ways of putting that kit together. So thanks in advance for your work on that. Next week, as I said, we'll continue with some of the graduates. Also, there's a few. Jenna, Natalie, and Everett have all graduated this year also. And I forgot to get Don Wertela's, one of folks in his family also has graduated. So we'll keep you up to date with that. Next week is book group. So they moved it up a week. Check your newsletter for what they are discussing for that. Crystal, anything else I'm forgetting for the good of the community? All right. Seeing none, we begin our worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, In the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia. Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria, Alleluia, Alleluia,
Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with
you. Let us pray. O God, you are the tree of life, offering shelter to all the world. Graft us into yourself and nurture our growth, that we may bear your truth and love to those in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
All right. Thus, oh, the first reading is from the book of Ezekiel. And I fear there's a mic open on in the. So I'll test it again. The first reading is from Ezekiel chapter 17. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will take a sprig from the lofty top of a cedar. I will set it out. I will break off a tender one from the topmost of its young twigs. I myself will plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain height of Israel, I will plant it in order that it may produce boughs and bear fruit and become a noble cedar. I'll finish this reading and then maybe someone in the chapel will finish it. So on the mountain height of Israel, I will plant it in order that it may produce boughs and bear fruit and become a noble cedar. Under it, every kind of bird will live. In the shade of its branches will nest winged creatures of the Lord. And all the trees and flowers shall be known that I am the Lord. I bring low the high trees. I make high the low trees. I dry up the green trees and make the dry tree flourish. I, the Lord, have spoken. I will accomplish it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shall I try for the second lesson, or does someone there want to take it? All right, good. I'll give it a go. The second reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. So we are always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please him. For all of us must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense for what has been done in the body, whether good or evil. Therefore, knowing the fear of the Lord, we try to persuade others. But we ourselves are well known to God, and I hope we are also well known to your consciences. We are not commending ourselves to you again, but giving you an opportunity to boast about us, so that you may be able to answer those who boast in outward appearance and not in heart. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For the love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for us all, therefore all have died. And he died for all, so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for them. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow. He does not know how. The earth produces of itself first the stalk, then the head, and then the full grain in the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with a sickle, because the harvest has come." He also said, "With what can we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable will we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, which when sown upon the ground is the smallest of the seeds on grain. Yet when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs, and puts forth large branches, so the birds of the air can can make nests in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything in private to his disciples. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Wait, wait, Pisco. I'm trying to train my dog Pisco to wait on things. And when I throw the ball to her, I will often say, wait, wait, and then say her name, Pisco, at which point she is to go tearing after the ball to retrieve it. She's getting better, but she's still a chocolate Labrador. She's still just over a year old. And if I'm honest, I still often need to hold on to her collar before I can let her sprint after that ball. My wife says that I sound like that voice when you're at a stoplight waiting to cross on the crossing walk. Wait, wait, wait. Crosswalk is open. Crosswalk is open. Maybe that's really not a bad analogy for what I'm trying to get across. I know, for instance, that hunters do such training with their dogs so the dogs know when to retrieve and don't jump the gun, so to speak. I don't know how Pisco will grow with this idea of waiting, but I am planting the command in hopes that I can keep her safe and keep others safe as well. I feel like in our gospel today, Jesus is commanding us, or at least asking us, to wait. Wait. I think he is also saying that while we plant and pluck up what is planted, God is in charge ultimately of the growing. Jesus says for us today, the kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground and we sleep and rise night and day and the seed would sprout and grow. The sower does not know how. Farmers in Jesus' day did not really understand how seed germinated and grew. They knew it needed to have good soil and water and sun helped. And they noticed rhythms at that time in the rhythm of the cycles of the earth. But ultimately, their hope was placed as the seed was placed. And the waiting game would begin. Wait. Wait. I love that line. The seed would sprout and grow, and the sower did not know how. How many times in our lives does that ring true? We want to believe that we know the answers, that we are somehow in control, that the best practices can force our control on how things will grow. And this may even work for a while. However, there is, after all, so much we still do not understand. This mysterious kingdom of God, being like a seed text in Mark's gospel, meets us in a time where there is still so much we do not understand. And yet somehow we trust that as the seed is scattered, be that seed which stands for the word of God or whether it stands for our very hopes and dreams, will provide a harvest of sorts, sometimes even in spite of ourselves. I've had several conversations with pastors of churches that are growing in numbers, and I would argue that the best of them don't really understand why they are growing. I once had a seminary friend who went to a struggling inter-Minneapolis church right out of seminary. She would talk to me about how she read all the books of best practices, went to the best conferences, and still the large church building that she was preaching in and being leading in still sat mostly empty. She felt like that big cavernous church was taunting her. Well, then she received a call to a large suburban church that seemed to grow by leaps and bounds. And I remember having a conversation with her about how she loved that call and that all was going so well with her, and I was so happy for her. Except as we ended the conversation, she said, "Eric, all you need to do is preach the gospel and love your people and things will grow." And I sat there and I wondered, weren't you the same pastor that was in that struggling congregation? Same pastor, reading all the books, doing all the right things, loving your people. And that understanding of growth didn't quite make sense. Yes, there is growth in numbers, but more importantly, I was reminded that there was a hope of growth in faith when we think about how growth works. And sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't, and we don't really understand why, only that it seems to happen in God's time. During my interview with this congregation that happened now just over a year ago, I haven't quite been here a year, but the interview happened. I remember asking the congregation if they were willing to grow. Sometimes as a congregation, if we get to know each other too well, we become less open to other people entering into our midst. I was assured this congregation was willing to grow, but I remember one of the people responded to my conversation, and I can't remember who. I think I might know. But she said, "Well, let's think about what growth means. Do we mean just in numbers?" And she said, "I would hope that we'd grow in faith and hope and love." And that is the idea. Those pastors who don't really know why their congregation has remained healthy and found growth tend to understand that they could just as easily be serving a congregation that is struggling to keep its doors open. The seed would sprout and grow, and the sower does not know how. If God is ultimately in charge of the growing, and God is, then what are we to be up to? Well, this is where our hope comes in. The image gives us hope in the seed's own automatic trajectory of growth. People like, Theodore Parker, Martin Luther King Jr., even Barack Obama might well agree, even if their words and images differ. The arc of the moral universe is long, but it tends to bend toward justice. Isn't that our hope? Even in Scripture, we talk that way, that Scripture, the Word of God, is not the static thing, but it is arcing in a trajectory for us to learn and to grow with God as God continues to plant what God tends to plant. And so even Jesus' seedy kingdom can sound good enough for people like us. The waiting game is long, but the one who knows our name will call it. In a few minutes, Elena Frances, who is getting to use the children's table over there in the corner, will be baptized. We baptize all ages around here. We baptize infants and children because we believe that the first decision that is made in our life of faith is God's decision. And we then will be encouraged to respond each and every day of our life. Sometimes we'll do well with it. Other days we will struggle to believe. But God makes the most important and biggest decision. So for a second, I'm going to address Elena's parents, Lainey and Felipe. You are doing the planting of Elena's faith. But remember that God will do the growing. Her sponsors, her grandparents, the community of faith that surround will all be put in place by God to help Elena as she grows in years. Amongst her will be coaches, maybe football coach. I don't know what sport she might play. All her teachers, her dentists, her doctors, her caregivers, all of those people will have input, and you can't control all of it. But what I invite you to trust in is the hope that God will carry her from her baptism into the promise that is before her. Lainey and Felipe, you will have a fair amount of waiting as you watch Elena develop. But in the end, may you trust that the promises of God are sure. Through the pandemic, we have played a long waiting game. As we continue our journey out of pandemic, our waiting continues. Much like our faith, our prayer is to know when to act and when to wait. So in the meantime, I encourage you to continue to scatter the seeds of God's word, of God's love, of God's grace. The harvest will come, and your name will be called, and we can go tearing after it. Wait, wait, Pisco, John, Christine, Lainey, Elena, Kevin, people of God, tear after. Amen. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Amen.
Gather at the river where bright angels feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. On the margin of the river, washing up its silver spray, we will walk and worship ever on the happy golden day. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful shining river, lay we every burden down. Grace our spirits will deliver and provide of a robe and crown. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the that flows by the throne of God. Soon we'll reach the shining river, soon our pilgrimage will cease, soon our happy hearts will quiver with the melody of peace. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God.
All right, at this time I'd like to invite the baptismal party up. And then, Crystal, have you found the...
I believe, yeah, and we're going to double
Yes. So, Josh, you're going to be spotlighted as well. I'm going to have you come right over here, and we'll have you face that way. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. Set to go? All right. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through this sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death, raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for life in the world. So I'm going to ask now, who presents this child for baptism?
We present Elena Frances for baptism.
That's okay. All right. We trust, we couldn't hear it here, but we know everybody else could hear it. So I have a thing for the sponsors now and for the parents. As you bring Elena to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with some responsibilities. To live with her among God's faithful people, to bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, the Ten Commandments, to place in her hands the Holy Scriptures, and to nurture her faith in prayer so that she may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, to care for others and the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. So I ask parents and sponsors, do you promise to help Elena grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Sponsors, do you promise to nurture Elena in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church?
I do.
People of God, do you promise to support Elena and pray for her in her new life in Christ? If so, now answer, we do.
We do.
We do.
Now, I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin, and to confess the faith of the church, the faith in which we baptize. Do you renounce all the forces of evil and all the forces that defy God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? I renounce them. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified under Pilate,
and was buried.
He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us come before God. Let us come before the triune God in prayer. Holy God, you plant the seeds of faith in every nation. Enliven your church so that the good news of your grace may root and grow throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creator, even the trees, shrubs, and flowers delight in your goodness from the depths of the soil to the highest mountains. Bring forth new plants. Restore growth to places suffering drought. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Judge of nations, we pray for our leaders and those in power. Grant them the ability to regard those under their charge with humility, dedicating their lives in the service to others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Divine Comforter, You show compassion to those in need and provide relief to those who call on you. Today, we pray for Sandy and Mark Rainey and their families on the death of Sandy's stepfather, for the mother of Brian Stoner as she recovers from health issues, for Joanne Gulsvig, who is in hospice care, for Eunice Kerr's husband, Chuck, facing an illness, and for Diane Masson, Jenna Wise, Cameron Wisekeever, and Don Wertela, whose baptismal anniversaries are this week. For what else do the people of God pray?
I give thanks for the life of John Olson. Pray for Laura, Harriet, and Mary. Pray for John's father who's in the hospital. We pray for our struggling democracy and democracies around the world and for the immigrants who are seeking lives of peace.
Bless all who suffer, especially people trapped in cycles of poverty and homelessness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Eternal God, we give thanks for our ancestors in the faith who are now at home with you. We look forward to that day when we are reunited in new creation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For what do the people of God give thanks?
We give thanks for Pam Geist's successful treatment of breast cancer. Oops, they're going a little fast, just a minute. For traveling mercy for my family this week. For the rain, for the life of Mike Pittman, for more rain.
Give thanks for Elena, who is baptized in just a moment here.
For Elena, who will be baptized in just a moment.
For Kevin Ward, as he goes to ventures, which he does not know where it will lead. And for David as well.
For our graduates, for Kevin and for David. I give thanks for all the children in my life and all the physicians and nurses.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We lift our prayers to you, O God, trusting in your abiding grace. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters. And by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family through the sea. And you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
All right. Elena, we're going to get you wet. Want to play in the water a little bit? Elena Frances, child of God, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'll give this to you and you can keep that. All right.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Amen. Sustain Elena Frances with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Elena Frances, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. I anoint your lips that you may speak God's truth. I anoint your ears that you may hear God's word clearly in your life. I anoint your eyes that you may see God's glory. I anoint your hands that you may do God's work in the world. And I anoint your feet that you may walk humbly with your God. Amen. This candle is a gift. And what's the date today? The 12th? Should be 13th? 13th. Should be lit on the 13th to remind Elena that she is a child of God. And so sponsors, I'm going to ask that you keep this date in your book as well. And grandparents that are joining with us as well, and friends, help Elena remember that she is a baptized child of God who is loved and cared for, and nothing can take that promise away from her. And we say to you, Elena, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good work and glorify your Father in heaven. Amen. So, for those of us gathered and even via Zoom, let us welcome the newly baptized.
We welcome you into the body of Christ
and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the newest member of the faith here, Elena Frances Alonzo Millar. So we'll give her a clap here, and all of you on Zoom can be doing this. The peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share a sign of that peace one with another, either via Zoom. Feel free to put yourself on the larger, what's that called, the view, anywhere you can see each other. And let your videos be shown for a moment, and greet one another with a sign of peace. God's peace to you all. God's peace, everyone that is here. God's peace, Elena. God's peace to you. Thanks for being so great. You actually kind of smell, and she can always play in the water. So this is just frankincense. Little frankincense. Yeah, that's what that is. That's what that little smell is. And this, you can blow that out.
In the
Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty.
I think we dressed. Did I jump the gun on something there?
I think you did.
Okay. All right. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, the body for the life of the world.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
The Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Maker, Redeemer, and Healer, in the harmonious world of your creation, the plants and animals, the seas and stars were whole and well in your care. When sin had scarred the world, you sent your Son to heal our ills and to form us again into one. In the night in which he is betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for them all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his acts of healing, his body given up, and his victory over death, we await that day when all the peoples of the earth will come to the river to enjoy the tree of life. Send your Spirit upon us and this meal. As grains scattered on the hillside become one bread, so let your church be gathered from the ends of the earth, that all may be fed with the bread of life, your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Gathered around the table by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This is the body of Christ given for you, and this is the blood of Christ shed for you. Taste and see that the Lord is good. If you are at home, partake in communion now. We will kind of motion to you who are here when to come up for communion as we commune today. Karen.
Eat this bread, drink this cup. love. Trust in me and you will not thus. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Trust in me and you will not thirst. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Trust in me and you will not thirst. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Trust in me and you will not thirst. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup. Trust in me and you will not thirst.
And for you. And this is the blood of Christ shed for you. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the gifts of his body and blood, may they strengthen, keep, and unite us now and forever. Amen.
Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen. This time, I'd like to invite Kevin and his family to come forward, and Crystal to come up as well. And you can face this way. Put you on camera here, Hannah. So, because of the weather, we had hoped to have cookies and all those things, but Crystal made sure you have some cookies to go home with you. And David, we'll have to get you some eventually here. We'll get you soon. And then maybe we'll have some cookies next week as well for the graduates that are able to be here, out hopefully outside. What was that?
The more cookies, the better.
The more cookies, the better, always. So, we are glad that you are here, and look forward for this celebration.
Before Kevin and David, before you were ever formed, God knew you. While in your mother's womb, God named you. At your birth, God's breath filled you with life. Today we celebrate what you have become at this moment in time.
Yeah, it means that even though you've graduated from school, faith life, it continues with all the doubts and everything else that comes. So we hope that you'll come back often. We thank you. We thank you for being among us to share your gifts in this place. And we pray that this place has been a blessing to you as well. And thank you for being a blessing to us. We don't always know where the future takes us, but we want you to know that you have a place always to come back to call home. Whether you come here from week to week, whether you come once a month, whether you're coming back only on holidays, or just the occasional visit that brings you back to Eugene, this place can always be a place that is home for you. I invite, whether you're home or whether you are in person, to go ahead and extend your hands in an act of blessing. And actually, I ask the three of you to come around and place your hand on Kevin. And David, know we are extending our hands to you as well. So let us pray.
O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give them faith to go out with good courage, not knowing always where they will go, but only that your hand is leading them and your love supporting them. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
So, wherever it takes you, we hope that you will kind of keep us up to date. And David, the same. You got to keep us up to date where you're going and what you're up to. So, thanks for being a part of this. Now, receive the blessing for all of you. May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine on you with grace and mercy. May God look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We sing our closing hymn. You may. Thanks for coming.
Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia. Be not afraid, sing out for joy, Christ is risen, alleluia.
Go in peace. You are the body of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Hoorah!